So prepaid expense represents an amount which is paid in advance to an organization as a person or a person. So we say the amount is received by the person, therefore debit the receiver. So we don't actually debit the name of the person here, rather we indicate or represent the organization or the person to whom we have given the money in advance with the word prepaid expense. That is right. You know, it is called representative personal account. Now what we must do, we should minus it from the expense, because already we debited the expense with this year amount and next year's amount. So we have to remove the next year's amount from the expense. Technically, to remove an amount from an account which is previously debited is by crediting it when we have to suppose to reduce it. So it is two expenses or concerned expense account. Now, so these two are the adjustments for expenses. One is you have outstanding expense, other is prepaid expense. Now let us continue with incomes. How you have for expenses, there are two adjustments for your incomes. For your incomes, number three, incomes, you have in incomes, you have A, outstanding in outstanding or accrued income. Now, what is outstanding or accrued income? Though the treatment is same for both, there is a slight difference in outstanding word and accrued word. Outstanding means you have given service to someone and in return you did not receive the money from that organization or a person. So similarly, accrued means you have given the service. For example, you have given the service for 1 month. So this 1 month gets divided, let us assume, between this accounting year and next accounting year. So however, according to the terms of agreement, the amount should be received at the end of the month. So when 1 month period half is for, let us assume your accounting year is Jan 1st to December 31st. Now on December 15th you entered into an agreement to give some service to a customer, whatever may be. Now that service is for 1 month, so it will end when it will end, let us assume if the year is 2017. So 1 month from December 15th would be Jan 15th 2018. So this would be the 1 month for which we have entered into agreement to give the service. So if you see, technically 15 days are falling in accounting year 2017 and 15 days are falling in the next accounting year. So when we do final accounts to find the profit, it is comparison of one accounting year income with the same accounting year expense. But in this case, we are saying the amount will be received on a later date or at the end. So on 31st December, as per the accrual concept, 15 days revenue you should recognize and account in the year 2017 as income. So this is what is accrued income. What is outstanding income? Let us assume the same case. In this case, I am reducing the date to December 30. On December 15th, you entered the agreement and you have to get the money. Irrespective, it may be on the first day, second day or last day. But when you have reached 31st December, you have seen this, you did not get this income. So the day on which you are preparing final accounts, if a particular income you did not get and the due date is over, that is called as your outstanding income. Whether it is outstanding income or accrued income, the accounting treatment remains the same. So, what is the treatment? Since it is an income recognized, we should credit the income. So, when we have to credit the income, what we must debit? We must debit the name of the person or the organization which has to give you the money. Only difference is we don't debit the person or the organization. We use a representative name for it. The representative name would be same, outstanding or accrued income. So, my journal entry would be outstanding or accrued income account debit. So, what we must credit, because it is this year's income. So, in that concerned income should be credited. It could be rent received, it could be interest received, it could be commission received, it could be any other income that we should receive and we did not receive. Then the next would be income received in advance. Income received in advance. So, when it is income received in advance, it's opposite. That is, some portion of the income of next accounting year, you have already received it in this year and you have credited it as an income. Okay. So, that has to be removed from the income which is previously credited. The same example, let us say your accounting year is Jan 1st to December 31, we are taking our example accounting year as 2017. Let us assume, as previously discussed, on December 15th, you entered into agreement to give a service for 1 month to someone, and that ends on Jan 15th, 2018. So, 15 days in this accounting year and 15 days in next accounting year. In previous example, we have seen that we did not get the money, or we will get it on the last day. But in this example for income received in advance, I am saying the person has given the entire money on December 15th itself. That means that this income what you received is for accounting year 2017 and also for 15 days of 2018. So, that means you have to show 15 days of 2018's income in P&L account of 2018. So, now you have to remove from the income of this year. As a result, the entry would be, when we have to remove the income, when it is not income of this year and the income is already credited. See, income has to be credited. If it's previously credited, then in order to remove that amount, we have to debit the income. So, income account debit to income received in advance. This is representing the giver who has given you that income. Income and received in advance. Now, if you can simply understand the journal entries, you will be able to know the position of these items while preparing final accounts in trading P&L and balance sheet. For example, if you see closing stock, it is debited. Closing stock is debited and trading account is credited. So, this item, you prepare trading account. So, in trading account, closing stock would be appearing on the credit side. Similarly, the closing stock ledger gets opened because of this journal entry. As a result, it will show debit balance. So, any ledger showing debit balance has to be either expense or expenditure. Now, what is closing stock? It is expenditure. Why? It is unsold portion. Still, the resource is with you. So, if it is expenditure, then it is a real account, then take it to balance sheet. If it is an expense, it is a nominal account, take it to trading or P&L account debit side. So, that is how you have to remember. Now, coming to outstanding or accrued income, we said it is a personal account. At the beginning of the chapter, we discussed all personal accounts should appear in balance sheet. Now, this personal account is getting debited. So, any debit balance, a personal account showing debit balance, where we will take? Balance sheet asset side. Now, similarly, here is the income which is credited. Income is which account? You know, nominal account. Now, it is getting credited means it should appear in P&L account credit side. This is how you should remember or relate your journal entries while working your problems. Now, similarly, let us see this. Income is getting debited. So, income is actually what? It will appear in P&L account credit side. So, since you have to debit it, we will minus this amount on P&L account credit side from the concerned income. Now, here income received in advance, we said is a which account? Personal account. So, personal account is getting credited. Generally, personal accounts, always personal accounts are shown in balance sheet. So, personal account which shows credit balance will be shown in balance sheet liability. This is what you need to understand.